Hey everyone, ArdrethShadow here, and welcome back to Hush Hush. So previously, we had a storm coming in, which is still going. We had quite a telling date with Quill. We had a nice afternoon with Elle. And I ended up having to break Eero's heart, which I did not really like all that much. Like, even the music is kind of depressing now. But yeah, it was... Yeah, even now I'm still feeling kind of bad about it. We went from having this kind of... Wish I was around, I just wanna make you happier, baby. How would you say, like, this sort of star-crossed feeling where Eero was kind of falling in love and she wasn't sure, down to saying she never wants to see me again and decking me in the face. Anyway, we have what Mystic called a trap event in the park, but before we do that, let's go ahead and pay a visit to him ourselves.
Hey, welcome back.
And for this, you apparently need to have $7,777.
Can I get a thumbs up?
No. Okay, yes.
Right on. Let's do it. Elle's final secret is the hardest to see. The goddesses won't let us cheat, even me.
Alright, well, essentially I guess we're on our own here. Well, it's a good thing I have the guide here as kind of a backup, but the fact that her final secret is the hardest to see here is... That doesn't give me any good vibes at all.
That wasn't very helpful at all.
No, it wasn't.
You know what? I'm gonna refund you your money. I might need to invest in a stronger crystal ball.
Okay, well, I'm not complaining. And the guy does say that you're gonna get your 7,000 whatever back, so... I guess that's why... We got gypped! But hey, at least he was nice enough to... give us our money back. For getting gypped.
You must be causing quite a stir to wind up getting a fortune like that.
Tell me about it. Well. That was kind of abrupt. Alright. So, yeah. Let me see here. At some point, we're going to get a choice that leads to the chibi death here. But, well, I guess let's find out. Day 23 is looking pretty packed, so I don't know. Day 24, not so much. So let's see. Man, look at all this. And I'm wondering if I'm ever going to get that. Unless maybe... That event with Kelby and Lilianna in the park wasn't really... It didn't impact anything. It was just kind of a... To me, it just seemed like a silly little thing you could do to... Either make Kelby kind of piss off Lilianna or something or other. Anyhow. As you arrive at the park, the rain begins to let up a little. The dark storm shroud gives way to swaths of meandering, drizzling, inky clouds. And Joey's here, kind of I don't know. Does he feel that the game made me sad the last time I played it? And he's here, like... Or is he just being a little cheap, Le, and he just wants me to give him attention? Who can say for sure? As you step out of your car... Oh, the rain's coming back. You see Elle waiting on a park bench. She's twirling a pink parasol, which is much too frilly to be of any practical purpose. So would it be like one of those kind of decorative umbrellas you wear out for... Or, not wear, but you take out for like a stroll in the sun? As opposed to using for rain? When she sees you, she waves excitedly and rushes over.
Hello, good afternoon. I'm so happy you had time for a walk today.
Yes. Of course, even if I wanted to say no, I couldn't because the game won't let me.
The company is rather wonderful. I find it's quite challenging having an engaging conversation with just yourself.
Yes. Indeed it is. It would also be quite concerning, but... Let's not think about that too much.
Also, people tend to stare.
And judge you. And think you're a crazy person.
How are you today?
Depressed. I just broke a woman's heart and then she punched me in the face. And I feel like the most awful person in the world. I'm doing well. No, I'm not. It's nice to see you. Well, yes it is, but I'm not. Wow, I don't know what it is, but you look sort of sparkling today. Is it the rain? Walking without a place to go is neato. Alright, this is what you want to say here.
Oh.
Elle blushes and turns away slightly. She curls a finger in her hair and smiles abashedly.
Well, of all the things I could be any particular day, sparkly is probably one of my favorites.
Well, as long as you're not like one of the sparkly fairies from Twilight. Although, I guess, if I'm being honest, I probably would make an exception for you.
Shall we walk? Or stroll? I think I would prefer stroll.
Would a stroll just be a walk but fancier? No, well, why not? Dare I say, why not? Elle bends her elbow, offering for you to take it. You hook your arm in hers, and she hugs you tightly to herself for a moment. The two of you stroll the park for a short while, mostly talking about the weather and how best to dress during a tropical storm. Oh great, it's El Nino season. Although IRL right now, I think we're getting kind of close to El Nino season around here. It's only May, but it's already practically summer here. When you round the corner, you see Dimitri from the coffee shop handing out free samples. Okay, so we had Lotus being a hot bikini babe handing out free samples in the, or at the beach. And I guess now we have Dimitri kind of appealing to all the sensitive souls who might be wandering in the park in the rain.
Ah, my friends, please come to me. Bring me your happy faces, for I would like to pour coffee in them.
But then you'll burn my face off.
Hello, Dimitri. How are you today?
Oh, Miss Elle, I am so wonderful. And even more so now that you have strolled in my path. But wait, what is this? Perhaps Dimitri is interrupting a special moment. The two of you. You are, how do we say, lovers?
Why does Elle look a little bit unsure about that? We're not a... Elle suddenly freezes In surprise and shock, she grips your arm tighter, but you see the color drain from her face, clearly embarrassed, and making that face that I like so much.
Oh, well, you see, Dimitri.
Now Elle's face turns a bright shade of red, and seems to grow redder with each moment. What the? Back off, Dimitri! I don't like the sass! Oh wait, let me see here. Choice 3 leads to Elle's inconceivable death. Okay, well, as much as I don't want to say this one, it looks like that's what I have to actually say. Okay, well, I'm sorry, Dimitri. I'm going to be kind of a jerk to you.
Oh my. My apologies if I have said something untoward.
No, you're fine. I should be apologizing to you for being a jerk. God, what is it with me being a jerk today? And, well, the last video, too. I just feel like... Damn it, why do I have to keep being a jerk to people?
We haven't had... But I want to, except...
We're not... I never lie! You barely catch Elle before her eyes roll back and she faints.
Oh dear. Miss Elle, hold on. I shall call 911.
Oh god, what's happening? You ease Elle to the ground, but much to your horror, she appears to lose consciousness and die. Are you gonna tell me that she died of pure embarrassment? Dimitri calls an ambulance, but it's too late. She did die of embarrassment! Elle has died of embarrassment, which is apparently a thing. Elle died, but it made no sense. The ambulance takes her away. You walk back to your car and sit shell-shocked until it truly dawns on you that your quest has failed. What the? You'll need to be suave to power through this scene. Unless the rumor about you and Elle was actually true. What rumor? Yeah, Elle's embarrassingly bad and they're just staring at me judgingly and disappointed. And yeah, she's missing. So the only one that I need the chibi death for now is Cassie. Okay, well, let's load back in.
You are dead, dead, dead. You are dead, dead, dead.
Thought you were hot, guess what? You're not.
You are dead, dead, dead.
Alright, well obviously, if they couldn't have given you a bigger hint at the end there, you do need the power of Suave here. Yeah, Lovers is perhaps a bit strong. There is certainly much to love about Elle, but I would say we're closer to Sweethearts right now. There we go. And I guess Dimitri's kind of okay about that. He's like, you have given me much to think about. Elle gasps slightly at your words, which seem to shake her out of her self-conscious panic attack, which could have led to her dying of pure embarrassment.
Oh, yes, of course. Excuse me. I did not mean to use such a powerful term.
No, you're all right. And she's doing the face again.
So often I am calling everyone lovers. My customers, my plumber, my banker.
What the? Okay. Great, now I have this weird image of Dimitri hitting up a non-copyrighted version of a plumber who clearly doesn't do things like wear overalls and say, "Let's go!" And as for a banker, Will, you're on your own there. Elle hugs her arm to herself and smiles serenely at Dimitri.
"Yes, Dimitri. Love is a strong word, but I look forward to saying it someday."
Well, hopefully we will. And hopefully nothing... who am I kidding? Well, considering I haven't gotten the tragic deaths at all, there's no telling.
Aha, yes, Miss L. We all do. And may we all find it someday.
Amen to that. As a hopeless romantic at heart, I do agree with that.
Here, have 2 samples of the best coffee in the park. Drink it and enjoy life.
You and Elle take the drinks and continue on your walk. Elle clings to you warmly for the whole trip and kisses you softly goodbye when she leaves, twirling her parasol. Probably trying to look like Princess Peach and, well... If I'm going to reference Mario and I have Mario on the brain, why not? God, I'm at 97 suave now. Okay, we have an event at the mall and the cafe. Where do I want to go? Okay, apparently, well, it doesn't actually tell me, but apparently it looks like I'm going to the cafe. Unless Lotus is somehow at the mall. Dropping by the Queen Bean, once again, you happen upon a less busy time. You can see Dimitri and Lotus through the door. You are likely in for another Lotus lesson. You step inside, and sure enough, Dimitri announces you with arms wide open and obvious joy.
Ah, there you are. The Cyrano of Sabrosa. The Casanova of... also Sabrosa.
Yeah, I guess that's me.
Lotus, the love doctor has returned.
Yar, I be a doctor. A doctor of love. Love.
Lotus appears from the kitchen with obvious worry. Oh, great. Well, yeah, we had that whole thing of them competing against each other for Alice, and that was very, very weird. So.
Dimitri, I told you already, no more Lotus lessons.
Okay, apparently he's even coined the term Lotus Lessons.
I'm seeing someone now. I got a date all on my own. And it's nice. And I don't need to flirt with strangers anymore.
Oh well.
So please, just serve our special friend like a normal, helpful, attentive barista.
Man, she really... It's like she really had it, I guess.
Ah, but Lotus, that is exactly my point. You have taken the skills you have learned and done well with them. But you must be ready for the road ahead. The last 3 lessons, the people you were flirting with were all very into you. It is time for you to flirt. With a grouchy person.
What? But... hold on, I'm just here like, what? But she already has somebody. Sort of. She's dating somebody. So I'm here like, why does she need to flirt with somebody else now? Oh my god.
No. Look, our friend just wants a coffee, yes? We are all done with the Lotus lessons.
Well, I mean, Dimitri has a point. I actually would love to grab a coffee and go. Come on, Lotus. You've done the lessons. It's time for your final exam. Which is what we have to say here. Oh, man. What the? Why does she look so happy about it, though? Lotus purses her lips in contemplation. She scratches the back of her neck for a moment, deep in thought, then gives you a nod. Yeah, why? Okay, I was here like... First you're here like, I'm done with the Lotus lessons, and now you're here like, okay, I'll do it.
Okay, one last lesson. The final exam.
The final showdown with Sheehan. Okay, no, not the final showdown with Sin.
Yes, haha. This will be our finest hour.
Okay. Tune in next week for Woody's Finest Hour! Alright, next episode, next tape! Alright, well. Well, luckily, it's not cancelled, so.
Alright, here is what Dimitri is thinking.
Oh no, he's thinking.
There is a certain customer that comes in every week at a certain time. She is, how do you say, very prickly.
No! You're not talking about Lilianna, are you?
Oh, God. You might as well just... We might as well just start making the tombstone for Lotus right now.
Dimitri, she hates me. She hates everyone. She's always so rude and cold.
Even though her voice is pretty sexy, yeah, I have to agree with you on that. I'm pretty sure she hates me and she wants to kill me.
Yes, the last time I mentioned her eyes were like moonlight in the starry sky. She threatened to kick my cojones up there too.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
She is fire. She is passion. And she is also a bitch.
Yeah, you got that right. Yeah, I guess she probably makes Audrey from Honey Pop look like Bambi in comparison.
She is perfect for your final challenge.
Oh, God. Just put an F on that final exam and let her go home.
Dimitri, there's no way I can flirt with someone like that.
Yeah. At least, you can, but there's no guarantee you're gonna make it out of there alive.
She's likely to make me cry, and I hate crying while I'm at work.
Do not worry, dear sister. If she turns up the meanness, I shall step in and throw her out. No one will speak to my sister this way.
Alright, you just pick her up and toss her into the streets.
Aww.
Aww. She's so cute when she's grumpy.
Well, okay. If you got my back, Dimitri, I'll give it a go.
This is gonna be insanity.
Yes, excellent. Are you with us, friend?
I know the type. We got this. She sounds scary. That is all. Let's seduce the crap out of this fiery lass, which is what we have to do.
Yes, the game is afoot.
Oh, man.
Oh, God.
Hey, that's the thing that I say.
Okay, we need only wait 15 minutes. Then she will be here. She is like clockwork.
Yeah, she only comes in when it's super quiet. I guess she likes solitude.
And places that there will be no witnesses, or as few witnesses as possible.
All right, we lay the trap, we wait.
You hide yourself out of view, where Lotus can see you and wait. sure enough, 15 minutes later, a beautiful but intense girl walks into the store. She appears to be sweating profusely from a workout. Or maybe it's just the rain. You don't know.
Hola, hello, aloha. Welcome to the Queen Bean.
Okay, she's not doing her usual thing. I guess Lilianna doesn't have time for that.
Hey, give me a double shot Americano.
Yep, there she is. She always has that hoodie up. And I just realized, does she have her app game on point? I think she does. Although I still don't think she'd be able to put up a fight against Maribel if she were around.
Absolutely! Can I interest you in a dessert?
No, just a drink. Be quick.
Well.
Oh, okay.
Lotus looks at you with a worried expression. She has no opening. Signal to compliment her abs. Okay, fine. Signal to introduce herself. Signal that it's on the house. Well, you know me. Don't worry, we'll load back. Lotus looks at you in shock. She shakes her head for a moment, but after you nod in reply, she sighs and accepts her fate. Don't worry. I'll rewind time before she does anything. I promise.
Dimitri will get your drink. So, I couldn't help but notice.
What?
Your abs are just incredible. Like, truly remarkable. Like, I could stare at them all day.
Oh my god. No, this isn't punked. There's no Ashton Kutcher who's gonna come out and tell you that you got punked. Lilianna stares at Lotus as though she's crazy. You're right, she's crazy. She's crazy in love with your abs. She looks side to side as though looking for a prank camera.
Are you messing with me?
Yes. Yes, I am.
Oh, no, I just...
Just give me the drink. Hurry up.
Okay. So let's go back. And what we're supposed to say is tell her that it's on the house. Lotus nods. She takes a deep breath to gain her confidence back and smiles.
Dimitri will get your drink. And today, it'll be on the house.
Lilianna looks at Lotus, confused. She raises her hands and shrugs.
Why?
Because I like you.
Oh, I sometimes like to buy a drink for customers.
Because I like them. Okay, no. I'm not helping.
When they, you know, catch my eye.
Oh, look at her go. I don't even need to give her any input for that.
And what exactly do you mean by that?
It means that she thinks you're scary as hell. Okay, no. Well, I mean, you kind of are, but... Lotus gulps audibly. Yeah, I heard that. You can see her begin to sweat.
I just think you're very interesting.
Yes, that's one word for it.
I see. Well, that makes one of...
That means you don't think you're interesting. You can see Lilianna stop her insult mid-sentence. She shakes her head and chuckles a little. Oh my god, you made her laugh! That's your first victory of the day!
My bad. Looking a gift horse in the mouth for no damn reason.
Oh my god, this is so... Well, it's not exactly cursed, but it's like, wow. You actually see her kind of blushing and looking a little, like, off guard there. So much so that I need to take a picture of this so I can just be like, hey, was that real? Yes, it was.
Thanks, but I'd prefer to pay.
Oh, okay.
So what's the damage?
What damage?
Excuse me? Sorry?
Oh, do you mean, like, how much is it gonna be?
What do I owe you? How much is the coffee?
Okay, yeah.
Oh, sorry. Double shot Americano. That'll be $5.
Here.
Lilianna tosses a bill onto the counter. Dimitri begins making the espresso, giving you a worried look that you're running out of time. Yeah. Understatement of the year. I'm running out of time in this game. I only have like 7 days left, maybe. Lilianna takes her phone and begins to look through messages. Lotus also gives you a quick look that says, what now? Ask her for her name number. Signal to ask her out. Signal to ask if you can help her out. Okay, you want to signal if... or ask if you can help her out. However, though, as we've established... let me just see. Lotus nods and take a deep breath to get into the zone. I feel bad, like I'm essentially sending her into the den of lions at this point. And we have a fiery lioness here who could probably... you know, I wonder who would win between her or Dea from Genshin Impact. You know, ignoring the obvious, that Dea can use fire and all that.
Dimitri is almost finished. Say, do you think maybe you'd like to get a drink sometime?
Lilianna looks up at her, surprised.
What? You mean like you and me?
Yes, clearly. In perfect harmony.
Yeah, why not?
Dare I say why not?
Is that why you're acting all squirrely? You want to ask me out?
No.
That is my system, yes.
Well.
Well, nice as that sounds, I'm not interested.
Well, she's actually smiling and, well, at least she's being kind of nice about it. Alright. That actually went a lot better than I would have expected it to. Okay. Lotus nods and takes a deep breath to get into the zone.
Hey, while Dimitri is getting our drink, can I ask you a question?
Sure.
Why are you so goddamn evil?
Is there anything I can do to make your day better?
So that way you'll stop being so grumpy? Well, actually, no. Grumpy is the... like, she's beyond grumpy. Let's be real.
What the hell are you talking about?
It's just that you come in here a lot and... I think you're beautiful and interesting and mysterious. Honestly, I probably built up a little crush on you.
Oh, look at her go. Yeah, she just totally took the shot, and I had nothing to do with it. Yeah, she just went in and said, like, hey, I think you're beautiful and interesting, and you got that aura of mystery about you that has me so interested that I can't help but feel a little something-something for you.
But you always seem so out of sorts. I'm not sure. I don't want to pry, but I thought maybe I'll ask if I can help. Maybe we can grab a drink sometime? Or just chat?
Liliana's face becomes stony and expressionless. She remains quiet for a long time, and you have no idea how she'll react. Yeah, this is actually, like, I'm here on the edge of my seat practically here, like, oh god, what is she gonna do now? Finally, she lets out a sigh and shakes her head.
Listen, that's awfully sweet of you. Normally, I would punch any prick who tried to get into my business.
Yeah, and that's kind of what I was afraid of. I was almost afraid, are you actually gonna, like, physically assault her in any sort of way?
But you seem truly, honestly nice, so I'm giving you a pass. The kinds of problems I got, you can't help with. And a girl like you, you don't want to get mixed up with a girl like me.
Because you're so nice and innocent, and you're like, you raided the wife of Satan's closet, and yeah, I just need some devil horns right here, and that'll complete the look.
Thanks for the offer. I can tell you've got a good heart, and a body I wouldn't mind pinning to a bed for some fun.
Hello.
But let's keep this professional.
Okay. Thank you for telling me all that.
Yeah.
Here you are. A double shot Americano. Made with loving hands.
You're not getting any.
Great.
Well, at least she seems to be in a good mood for the time being. Dimitri hands the cup to Lotus, who turns to hand it to Lilianna, while giving you one last look for input. Signal for her to write her number, signal for her to touch Liliana's hand, signal for her to do nothing. What you're supposed to do is signal to do nothing. However, just because I like to see what could possibly go wrong, Lotus nods.
Here you are!
Oh boy. Yeah, I saw that face. Lotus takes her cup, putting her free hand over Liliana's for good measure, and lets her hand stay there for a moment. Lilianna jerks away, almost spilling the drink.
Goodbye.
Okay. So, essentially, don't push your luck. So, yeah. I guess if it wasn't clear enough, there's really nothing else you can do. Unless you want to really, really push her luck. Lotus nods.
Here you are! Enjoy!
Thanks.
Lilianna turns to leave and Lotus frowns slightly. You can tell that she feels she needs to add something, but restrains herself from doing so. Yes, because as I just saw from another timeline, if you do anything, she's probably just going to get kind of angry. Just as Lilianna gets the door, she turns back herself.
Hey, listen, Lotus?
Oh?
Yes?
I'll think about it.
Oh, hello.
Great! I mean, good! Thank you!
Later.
Lilianna pushes her way through the door and walks down the street. Pretty woman. Okay, no. It kind of reminds me of the end of that song, where it's like, is she on her way back to me and all that? Because, well, she did momentarily kind of go back, figuratively, and, you know, she left the door open for her, so who knows? After a few moments of silence, Dimitri speaks. And, okay, after this, none of the choices here matter.
Sweet melody, that was intense. I almost peed a little.
I wouldn't blame you.
But Lotus, you did so good.
He sounds legit proud of her.
I did, didn't I? She didn't threaten or yell at me? She didn't tell me she was gonna slap my boobs off or whatever?
I'm just... Trying to imagine that, that's like, oh god.
It was exceptional. You truly have become a master of the fine art of flirting.
That was actually fun. I didn't feel too scared, even though I was sure she was going to reject me at any moment. Or worse.
Or worse.
Thank you, you two. I actually do feel like I've learned a lot. Even just being brave enough to blur something out can sometimes work.
Yeah, that's actually what I've had some people tell me. The problem is, I don't feel brave enough to do that, exactly. Let's be real. I would feel, like, terrified just doing that. Like, even if it is just with a random stranger who I'm probably never, ever, ever gonna see again. Yeah, it just feels like, oh, man. I would not be able to do that. Not unless, like, I had a way to... Well, not blurt something random, but something with a purpose. Like, if it's, like, if it was in the my college days and being, like, asking about an assignment or something, kind of to get my foot in the door, you know. Versus just going up to a girl being like, you're pretty hot, and, you know.
I have never been so proud of you. Except that time you won that spelling bee.
Aye.
Dimitri, I was 5 years old back then.
And he was very proud of you. Come on.
Yes, and the word fuchsia is very hard to spell.
Yeah, because it doesn't sound like the way it's spelled, so obviously...
Goodness gracious, Dimitri.
That was fun. I've actually enjoyed these, despite having no idea what I was doing. I was only doing what the guy who was controlling me told me to do. The student has become the master. Only a master of evil doth. Okay, no. Can I get a coffee now? Can I go home now?
Oh, yes, of course. I got a little wrapped up in everything. Let me get you your drink. Here you are, a cup of my Super Brew Supreme.
And thank you one last time, my friend. I have never seen such confidence in my sister. Surely you have helped her level up her love stat.
This isn't Crush, though, and, well... Imagine Crush, but from Lotus's point of view. Something like that.
I don't know if I go that far. But thanks again. Having you drop in all this month has been fun and terrifying.
What, so I'm terrifying? Okay, well, I'm not terrifying, but...
Again, just like love.
Yeah, love can be fun, but it can also be terrifying, I suppose.
Come see us again!
Well... I'll be trying to see you all for the remainder of the month, so I'll make sure I do that.
But no more lessons. That was the last one.
Yeah, I don't blame you for feeling that way. I mean, especially if you're already dating somebody. I mean, yeah, it's kind of no point to it.
At long last, my sister, I agree.
Oh my god, the world's gonna end! Alright, no. Well, who knows, with the way this game is going so far.
Okay, let's get ready for the rush, Dimitri.
Today, I shall do the impossible.
Oh my god, maybe the world is gonna end.
I shall clean the bathrooms.
Oh, you know that's my least favorite job.
Yes. You have earned not having to scrub the toilets today. Take care, my friend.
See you again!
You step outside and take a sip of the Super Brew Supreme. It rejuvenates you like no other. Lotus Petals, you successfully helped Lotus flirt with Lilianna and got +3 to all your stats. Hey wait, that means I have 100 now! Yep. Okay. Can I keep adding more to my suave stats? How ridiculous can I make it? You feel ready to face every challenge ahead. Mio. Oh, right, Cassie's fourth date. Okay, well.
Hey! I'm going to be doing a stream tonight. If you feel up to it, I'd like you to watch it. Just so everything is out in the open. I want you to see me, but you don't have to. I respect whatever you want to do. I'll send you a link. Talk soon.
Alright, well, let me see here. Alright, so you are going to be attending her stream. And I suppose that's kind of what's gonna make this day go on a little longer. But okay. We can totally ignore her and go to the bakery, or obviously, yeah, we're gonna go to her fourth date. Minimum requirements: $250, 42 motivation, 62 suave, and 41 buff. None of which has any meaning to me anymore, especially here. God, I'm just here like, does it cap off at any point? Or can I just keep making that number as ridiculous as possible? Well, I guess we can find out pretty soon. Okay, we're here at the mall. You drive up to the mall to pick up Cassie, after she insisted last minute that she needed to get her hair done. Oh yeah, go get your hair done, and get your nails done while you're at it. Alright, no. Well, ah! Luckily it's not very busy today, and you find a loading zone to park in temporarily while you wait for her.
The white zone is for immediate loading and unloading passengers only.
Surprisingly, she steps out of the front entrance just as you pull up, and for a moment you don't recognize her. Oh my god, who is this beautiful stranger? Obviously somewhat self-conscious, Cassie walks over to the car with her hands folded out in front of her. She looks amazing.
Good evening. Are you the carriage I sent for?
Wow, Cassie, you look amazing. Yes, though we should hurry. I turn into a frog at midnight. Aye aye. Beautiful as always, but breathtaking in particular. Okay, Keanu Reeves. And, well, yep, we want to be Keanu Reeves for this. No, you're breathtaking!
Oh gosh, you're gonna make me blush. You really know how to make a girl feel wanted. You know that? Well, I'm starved. It's been a coffee and gummy bear kind of day. I need protein, stat!
Well, okay. Oh my god, yes! We can make the swap stat as ridiculously high-leveled as possible. If there is a level cap, I doubt I'm gonna find it. Alright, well. I'm gonna be the suavest person in this whole... in all of Sabrosa. The drive out to the winery is pleasant. Although the weather has been rainy recently, today the air is calm and brisk. Cassie puts on a few songs she wants you to listen to and sings along. A lot of classic rock and trashy pop songs. At one point she leans way, way over to smell your cheek. She then compliments your deodorant and gives you a smooch. She finds this particularly funny, and laughs for the last 6 or 7 minutes of the drive. When you arrive at the winery, it's much more chill than usual. There are no fancy parties, and the small restaurant has set up tables throughout the vineyard for extra ambience. But does it still look like a wedding reception? Well, I guess we're not going to see it. Oh, wow, look at this place. It looks like magic. Like, when did we enter the movie Tangled? As you're escorted to your table, Cassie appears nervous.
Good lord, look at this place tonight. I've got everything all fancy tonight. Look at the lights.
And at last I see the light. Okay, no.
Hey, listen, I just wanted to say thanks for taking me out again. I know our last date had its bumps, but you're a real trooper for sticking with me.
But I'm not like Steve the trooper. Alright, no. No sweat. I just got over the embarrassment. It's all good. Oh my... It's my pleasure, Cassie. I enjoy every moment we spend together. I'm also looking for a reason to dress up and show off the goods. Oh, well. We actually have to say that one.
I knew it! I'm just a bit of arm candy for you to accessorize with. Well, either way, you look smoking hot yourself. So as long as those muscly arms find their way around me at some point, it's gonna be a good night.
The two of you sit, and the waiter pours you each some wine. You can tell Cassie is somewhat uncomfortable as she fidgets and pulls at her own hair, and as ArdrethShadow stumbles on his words. She notices you noticing her, and that's when she puts you on notice that she noticed you too, and stops. She immediately has a sheepish look.
I'm sorry, I'm just... so worried about doing something wrong or saying something rude.
So I guess she's a little self-conscious about herself since the last date.
When I was really young, my Nona took me out to a real fancy place and told me I could order anything I wanted. So I decided to order pizza. Cause, you know, pizza, it's flippin' great.
Well, can't argue with that.
But when I said it, she gasped super loud and the waiter laughed at me.
Aww.
And then they both gave me lectures on how that's not the kind of food you order at fancy places.
Well then. Yeah, I was here like, well... I don't know if there's such thing as like a fancy pizza restaurant out there. Like, is there something like that out there in the world? Because I've never seen one. And I'm not talking about like New Yorker style pizza or anything. I'm talking like, picture the restaurant that we went to before, and does it have pizza on the menu of any sort? You know, is there anything like that out there?
The other night, when I joked about ordering cheeseburgers, well, that was my sorry attempt to be charming and mischievous. I swear I'm developing a complex now. Fancy places make me nervous.
It'll be fine, don't even worry. Order whatever you like. I can't read the menu myself, I'm just going to have to point and pray. Yeah, this thing right here, that looks good. Yes, I'll order 10 of them. Don't be nervous. You're beautiful, sharp, ferocious. If I could just stop stumbling on my words. You're beautiful, sharp, ferocious, and utterly charming. And that's what you're gonna say. Cassie goes quiet for a moment, a soft blush coming to her cheeks. You notice she twirls her hair a little and looks away, a bashful look you've never really seen before.
What are you trying to do to me over here? You're gonna make me blush redder than a radish! Jeez, Aloo.
Haven't heard that one before.
You're sweet. And quite observant, I must say. We'd better make with some small talk before I hyperventilate or something.
Alright, looks like we can... Or rather, yeah, we're supposed to go through all three of these. So, I guess why don't I just head on down the line here, since that's what the guide is kind of going for as well. So, how's work going?
Not great. Things have actually been pretty tense lately.
Uh-oh.
Apparently, there's been extra heat on the higher-ups. Too much attention from the wrong people. Luckily, not much of that reaches down to me. I'm just a pretty face doing my job. Now, if I was a ladder climber like Lilianna, I'd be feeling burned for sure.
Lilianna is the girl I saw you working with outside the cafe, right? What is Liliana's deal, anyway? Do you think someone might be... what's the term? Snitching? Okay, you want to say, what's her deal anyway? Yeah, like, what's her deal anyway? Like, gah!
What, like, is she available? You maybe want me to give you her number so you can hit her up for a booty call sometime?
No! Trust me, she would murder me if I did that.
Calm yourself. You're getting that, oh shit, Cassie's getting heated, look.
Well, can you blame me? You're looking pretty heated right now.
I don't know how to say this. She's in charge of my little team around here. I treat her like dirt, but that's just because she's rude as a cat with its ass stuck in a tin can.
Hmm. Okay, I can kind of see that.
Tough bitch, though. I saw her break a dude's nose. With her nose.
Do I even want to know how?
I wonder if they have good Prosecco here.
Let's see here. Now we're gonna say... I noticed you didn't acquire your dress tonight as usual.
Maybe observing that I wasn't a complete piece of trash just before our date started?
No.
Well, thanks for noticing. I've been trying to clean up my act a bit. Get off the naughty list. Of course I'm doing it to impress someone. I'm hoping they find me more attractive and do things with me in bed.
Hi-yo.
See this eye? It's winking. I'm winking at you.
I'm just impressed. You clean up good. You like me. By the way, I noticed a lot more than that. I'm actually still looking. And that's what you want to say, really. So. Cassie pulls her menu up over her mouth, looking around to see if anyone heard you before pointing an accused finger at you.
You behave yourself. You're supposed to look more quietly.
Oh, behave, darling!
Although I would like to point out that this is an awful window shopping. I'm fully expecting you to get your fingerprints on the glass later.
Well... if this was the other version of the game, probably.
Now behave yourself.
Alright.
A waiter's sure taking their time.
How's Alice D doing recently? And well, I mean, at least now, well, I mean, they said her full name, but I don't remember it anymore. So, but yeah, so we're gonna ask her, how is Alice D doing recently?
Oh god, that girl. She's fine. Literally made of stone. Nothing gets under her skin.
She's also very horny as hell.
Lilianna so much as growls at me, and I'm in a whirling dervish of anger and contempt all day. But last week, Alice literally gets robbed at knife point. She's laughing about it an hour later.
She was probably turned on by it, let's be real.
She's made of stern stuff. Only, it's also really soft. Because, I mean, let's face it.
Yes. Yes, how could I forget? Cassie raises her hands, mimicking two vast orbs in front of her chest.
She was asking about you, by the way.
Okay, well then. The two of you are friends, right? Well, I mean, if things don't work out between us, oh my... This guy here. I can't tell if you two are tight or just colleagues.
Colleague is a $5 word to describe our working relationship.
Really? Then how would you describe it?
We're... accomplices.
Well... As if I needed to... I mean, we already know kind of what's going on behind the scenes a little bit, but yeah, it just seems as though... Now we're just further painting that picture with more details.
By the way, if this is some wacky way to inquire if I'd be down with a threesome with you two, the answer is no.
I was not going to ask that!
Although I can assure you she would be. With bells and ropes and whatever Quasimodo bullshit you want to throw in.
Okay, does she want me to start ringing some bells for her? Is that what you're saying?
I'm way too vanilla for the likes of her.
Oh yeah. I'm still remembering that whole thing where Lotus and Dimitri were flirting with her. Oh my god. Oh, that was quite a bit.
A waiter sure taking their time.
You already said that. Okay. Well, I guess that's it here. Only one choice. Yes, there is. When are you going to bring you back to your place? Oh my... Man, way to really pressure her.
I don't know. I mean, I could ask you the same.
Well...
My place is just... Well... I feel like it maybe tells a little bit too much about me. It's hard to deny you're not trashy when you bring people back to your trash nest, you know?
The waiter returns and takes her order. Cassie immediately becomes more nervous, pulling out her hair again. Relax, or just relax. It'll be okay. You got this, girl. Cassie looks over at you, seemingly in surprise. She lets out a chuckle and rolls her shoulders, trying to relieve tension. You place your order, and Cassie takes a deep breath.
Beg your pardon, sir. I'm not very good at reading French. Some of this looks more Italian than French, so now I'm second-guessing what I'm reading. Can you tell me what the Neapolitan Margarita Esposito is?
Huh. Okay. The waiter tells her it's a flatbread margarita, prepared in a wood fire oven, in the Naples tradition.
It's a fancy pizza?
Oh my god, we found fancy pizza! Okay, well, my question has been answered. Cassie looks at her menu for a moment, stunned. She then bursts into laughter.
Oh my god!
The waiter looks surprised and somewhat stunned. They look to you. She just needs a minute. Break into roaring laughter, too. Yep, that's what you're supposed to do here. The waiter fidgets a little uncomfortably, but waits for the two of you to finish. Before she's finished, Cassie rises from her spot and walks over to you. She's now laughing so hard there are tears in her eyes. She places her hands on her chest with each enormous breath. When she reaches the side of the table, she leans in and gingerly kisses you. Her fingers, recently manicured, Ah, she did get her nails done. Caress the side of your head. And her kiss is soft and warm and full of life. Finally, her laughter abating, she sits back in her seat.
Oh God, I can't believe it! I beg your pardon, good sir. That was a bit of an inside joke.
Yeah. So now we know that there is such thing as fancy pizza out there.
I would very much like to order your fancy pizza.
The waiter smiles broadly, writes it down, and reminds you that the vineyard is for joy and romance. Well, I would like to hope that there is going to be some romance happening here tonight. Because I still can't get over the last video. He scoots off, and Cassie raises her glass.
Here's to joy and romance, I guess.
This choice doesn't matter. Cheers. Here's to you.
Gotcha, sweet cheeks.
The dinner goes well. Cassie raves over the fancy pizza and calls it God's gift to the world. At one point, soft music begins to play on the speakers hidden in the vines. Cassie sighs happily. This is going to be like Beauty and the Beast, Lady and the Tramp. Great, now I'm mixing up my movies.
Junk I've ever seen. I want to have the full experience.
I'm not much of a dancer. Rise and extend your hand.
I warn you, I'm wearing two left heels.
For real? Also, this choice didn't matter, so.
If I step on you, those heels are sharp. They're going straight through.
Well, then I guess just have an ambulance on standby. You and Cassie stand cheek to cheek and dance. The song is soft and slow, and the fabric of Cassie's dress feels unworldly in your hands.
This is so nice.
And you look beautiful tonight.
I wish this is how it always was.
I would like to say maybe it can be, but I have no idea anymore.
Look at me. You're turning me soft. I'm letting you. This is nice.
Why can't you be soft? I didn't do anything. I was just nice to a pretty girl. After I accidentally fell in and caught a peek at her changing.
How is someone not supposed to fall for someone else when that's the way they talk to him?
Cassie goes quiet for a while, and you catch out of the corner of your eye that she's holding a sad gaze as you dance. After a few moments, just as you're considering to say something, she whispers something.
Happy story.
Maybe save it then for now. You can be happy with me for a short while. You can tell me anything.
That's good. Because I want to tell you something I've never told anyone. The house I grew up in wasn't a happy place. I won't bore you with too many details. My mom had a lot of problems, and my stepdad was a drinker. Don't worry, he didn't put his hands on me or nothing, but he sure didn't like me. Even when I was 7, I was full of fire and brimstone, and I let him have it. We used to scream at each other so late and so long that the cops would drop by to break it up. Our nearest neighbors were almost 1,000 feet from us. We were loud! Anyway, I started getting into trouble in and out of school. Started skipping school. Started hanging around bad people. And my stepdad, well, he had had enough. He kicked me out. I spit in his face and he clocked me good. I had a black eye for a month. But I gave him one too before I ran off. So as far as I'm concerned, I came out ahead in that fight.
That sucks. I'm sure it was just a phase, and you evened out into a fancy girl. Somehow, I don't know if that's the kind of route we're heading into, just based on her story, because... Well, as Iroh's dad put it, she's had a rough life, so...
Ha! No.
What'd I tell you? Ha! No.
But I sure have some regrets years later. Anyway, I was out on my ass with no money, no place, no nothing. So I left the boonies and came to town, looking for a place to go. And that's when I met Mel. Mel found me in a bus station, stealing quarters out of the candy machines, and chasing off the animals, offering me $5 for a good time. She took me in and fed me pizza. It was good pizza. Kinda stale, but you know, pizza. Mel was older than me. I think she was 40. But she lived on the streets and did her best to help anyone she could stay warm and dry. She was good people. Like you.
Some of these next... few choices don't matter. From the sounds of it, I would not compare to her. I'm lazy and spoiled. You're talking about her in the past tense.
Yeah. I'm getting to that part.
See? We still have quite a bit to go, I imagine.
I bunked at Mel's place for almost 4 years. She made sure I never ended up in some pimp's menagerie or doing hard drugs under the overpass for an escape. She was my guardian angel. And one day, there was a lump right here.
Cassie pokes you in the chest, just beneath your left nipple.
Guardian Angel got really sick.
Either stay quiet or I'm sorry. I've never lost someone to cancer. Although I've lost people to chronic diseases. Of course, I've already talked about my mom in numerous other videos. Well, the choice doesn't matter, and... I almost feel like... What can you even really say to this, so...
And then... Mel needed a whole lot of help. See, that lump wasn't what you'd call the OG cancer. It was part of a gang. Breast. Pelvis. Rib. Things went from bad to worse real fast. And just the ride to the hospital alone took all the money she had. And she was just about making up her mind not to fight it when I told her not to worry. If she fought, I'd fight too. If she hung in there, I would figure out the money. I'd look after her. Take care of her and make her soup and change her diapers if I needed to. Because I loved her so much. So I did. I found the money and got a house already. Put ramps in and bars near the toilet and everything.
Cassie stops for a moment. A wild and desperate sadness flutters inside of her and suddenly pours out in a sob.
And then she died anyway! She died! Only 5 weeks later! Her hair didn't even fall out! I already had wigs for her to wear! She was just gone. I didn't even see her that day. It got suddenly bad overnight.
Cassie sobs into your chest for a while. Her whole body shuddering with the effort.
Oh God, I'm sorry. I didn't realize I was gonna.
There's nothing to be sorry about.
I haven't cried about this in years. I didn't expect it all to come back and hit so hard.
Well, I mean, the fact was you cared a lot about her, and the whole thing was just a lot of trauma and misfortune. Like, if I were to think back to my mom's final days, I'd probably start breaking down. But for my sake right now, I'm just kind of, like, I'm gonna try to kind of hold on and not think about that right now. But then, of course, at the time I'm recording this, May 13th, Mother's Day is coming up, so, well, you might say I'm going to have plenty of time to think about my mother and all those feelings I have from still missing her all these years later.
I've never told another person all this out loud. Anyway, I was left without anywhere to go and a pretty big bill to settle.
And I guess that's where these people she's with come into play.
The hospital was going to return a bunch of it, but then they would have looked into where it came from in the first place, and, well, I didn't get the money from no guardian angel, I'll tell you that.
Apparently this choice doesn't matter either. You got it from your current employers. Why did you tell me all this?
I'm not totally sure.
I suppose it's because she finally has somebody that she can really talk to about this stuff. Stuff that she probably hasn't spoken to about anyone about for years.
You to know. I trust you, and I guess I wanted you to know what was going on, why I made some of my decisions. You know? Play stupid games, win stupid prizes, I guess. And if you think any less of me for any of this, I hope maybe seeing more of the picture will explain some of it. I just needed someone to tell.
If anything, I feel like she was just dealt a very bad hand.
You're just the charming person who decided to drop into my life. Like an angel.
Thank you for telling me. I'm glad to know you better. Or what you're actually supposed to say or do. Stay quiet. Just dance a little longer. Cassie leans against your shoulder again, and the two of you dance for a while longer. After a long dance in each other's arms, a new song pops on, with a bit of a swing, and wakes Cassie from a dreamy stupor.
Whoa! Look at the time! We've been awkwardly making circles for a while now.
So it would seem.
I should get home. I've got a meeting tonight, an important one.
Oh boy.
Can we split?
You bet. I'll settle up. I'm about that. It looks like, oh boy. Man, way to make her, well, yeah, if you choose this, you're basically going to be, like, forcing her to pay the whole thing here. Okay, well. Let's see here. So, yeah, you're supposed to do this.
Awesome. I'll meet you at the car. I've got to check my makeup.
Okay, I'm going to save here really fast. I was just here making sure if I make any wrong choices, is it going to lead to a tragic death? And, well, not right away, it seems. Cassie is quiet for most of the ride home. She stares out the sky at the window, which has become once more clouded, as the forecast mentioned. It seems that way. A storm's coming. Hell is coming.
I get this feeling in my knees. The worse it is, the worse the storm will be. I'm gonna be one wise-ass witch. I'm gonna know it someday. I promise you that.
Pizzeria. When you arrive at her place, an apartment above the pizzeria, Cassie looks at you with a strange expression of sadness and desire. She leans over in her car seat and kisses you. She rubs the side of her thumb along your jawline, and for a moment, she's your entire world. When she finishes, she looks to you and smiles, and then she frowns. Okay, that's like, what? That's a weird way to invite me in for, you know, canoodling. Or something else if you're playing the other version. Cassie laughs lightly, but loses her smile quickly. Then get out, Cassie. Come with me. As you wish. Then let me in the game. I'm not leaving you.
No! There's no way I'm letting you throw all the good stuff in your life away. Listen to me. You're a good person. Stupid life I'm living. Messed up shit, and now I'm paying for it. There's only bad people over here. Bad people, and desperate people. And you're neither of those things. Don't be stupid. Just say goodbye to me, kiss me, and let's be done with it!
I'm not good. I'm worse than you think, and I won't take no for an answer. I'm not letting you go, Cassie. Hey, I can handle myself, all right. Don't worry. Cassie pulls away to resist your kiss, utterly furious that you would kiss her at a time like this. But you slip your arm under her waist and keep the awkwardness rolling. And as you predicted, in a moment, she melts and kisses you back. In fact, for a few dreamy moments, her kisses become rather passionate and have a take me, I'm yours vibe. But a moment later, she finally pulls away and says,
"God damn you. All right. But only because I think maybe you like me as much as I like you."
Cassie pushes you as far as she can, being seated next to you, and thinks, as though you might tackle her while she's distracted.
Alright, I need you to know that this was the worst decision of my life. But I'm not gonna stop you from making it. I just want you to know, I don't think it's worth it for me. But I'll let you make the decision. Go home. Think about it. If you decide you want in...
Cassie types a message into her phone and it pops up on yours.
Come to this address in 2 hours.
Oh boy.
Just know that. We can do things if you want to join.
So pretty much an initiation sort of thing. Let's see, this doesn't matter. Alright, I'll consider it. I'll see you in 2 hours.
Okay. Let me know if you're not coming. I'll make an excuse. Just don't make this choice lightly.
Yeah, because I imagine once you're in for life. So, you go home to change and to prepare. Quill is there, playing with the cord of the kitchen blinds. She seems happy. You decide to take most of the cards out of your wallet and pack a knife. You're not sure if it's a good idea or a bad idea. Probably both. Yeah, so we're not quite done yet here. Oh boy. And yeah, I'm just kind of looking to see. Yeah, the tragic deaths here, I'm looking for a moment, and it's possible. I don't know if this is where you're going to get it from, but I think you do have the option for the chibi death coming up really soon. After enough time has passed, you get back into your car and drive to the address Cassie gave you. During the drive, the rain comes and goes. At one moment gentle, almost non-existent. The next in a wild crescendo. As though the storm is selectively angry at the world, lashing out, mad as hell, and then going quiet. You cross several train tracks to reach your destination. The back of your mind makes a wrong side of the tracks joke you don't find particularly funny. Yeah, I think this is like understatement of the year. Well, sort of, and oh god, this music. Finally, the place you're heading to comes into view. It's a large, foreboding warehouse, clearly, obviously abandoned. Yeah, this music sounds like... Yeah, the music even sounds like, don't come in here unless you wanna throw your life away sort of vibe. Even as you step out of your car, you hear sounds coming from inside. Music. Yelling. You walk up and cautiously look inside.
What's cooking, good looking?
Okay, Alice is here. Alice's voice startles you, and you flail a little more than you're comfortable with in reply.
So, I wasn't really expecting this to happen.
Well, I guess I wasn't really either.
Cassie's been saying you're neat meat, that you want to join the family business and make a name for yourself, or something.
Yeah, sort of.
True.
Well, I mean, one of the other reasons is right here, in front of me. Ugh. Only one choice. True enough, I guess.
I see. Well, tell me, did Cassie tell you that she considers this the worst decision of her life?
Yeah, she did indeed tell me that.
Did she happen to mention that, were it not for an unfortunate and untimely closure of the strip club I used to work at, I would also have avoided this line of work like the plague?
Well, I guess now we know what else she was into.
And did she mention that there are no health or dental benefits?
Yeah, I kind of pictured that being the case.
If none of that scares you away, then follow me.
Oh, boy. Alice brings you into the warehouse where you see a group of delinquents hanging out. Most of them are smoking, hanging out on an old couch. At a nearby table, you see Lilianna talking to someone with several rolls of money in front of her. Cassie is with Lilianna, standing behind her in her jacket and cap.
She's a bit of a trophy around here. Cassie, I mean. All the kids have a thing for her, but they're more afraid of Lilianna.
Gee, I can't imagine why.
They learn pretty quick not to mix business and pleasure.
Yeah, I can probably imagine why.
Though they don't know it, but Cassie can take care of herself.
Doesn't matter. What are they going to do to me? Or what are they going to make me do? No, a better question one question I would have is, what are they gonna do to me? I wouldn't be here if she could do it on her own.
Hey, fair enough. I'm with you.
Are you?
Just be ready, 'cause...
Am I gonna get jumped?
Well, I almost said they like to play for keeps, but no one is playing here. Careful. We've got the odd psycho running around, always out for blood.
At that moment, Lilianna finishes up with the person she's talking to, and Cassie taps her on the shoulder. Cassie points you out, and Lilianna nods. The two of them walk over together, Cassie making no outward expression, Lilianna looking very much like a lion about to strike. I guess the lioness comparison was in character, I guess.
So, you're the stranger.
Apparently.
I've seen you around.
And I've seen you around.
Cassie tells me you want to get paid. She says you know how to keep your mouth shut. And you can fight.
Yeah, I feel like we're gonna have a real fight club going on here now.
Is all that right?
Only one choice. Yeah, where's your boss? That's not half. Yeah.
I don't believe you.
Well, I can't choose the other options, even if I wanted to.
I know a punk ass when I see one. Let's find out if I'm wrong. We gotta make sure you're not a cop. Test is a little different for everyone. Pretty straightforward. Dan, come here.
One of the delinquents walks over. You recognize him from your first date at the mall with Cassie. Okay, it's this guy.
Hey, I know this bitch!
Gee. He sounds awfully excited.
Shut up. Dan is also new. He just joined last week. He also turned 17 last week.
Okay. Why?
I want you two to fight. Whoever wins moves on to the next round.
What? But I already... You know what? Screw it. You want me to beat the crap out of this punk? That's a big hell yeah for me.
Alright. Okay, so you're gonna basically say he's just a kid. Choice 3 leads to a bad end. It looks like I'm probably going to be making a lot of different saves here, just on this alone. So choice 3 leads to a bad end. He's just a kid. Try not to swallow your tongue, kid.
Yeah, that's why it's illegal.
Yes, I can kind of see that.
Make it happen.
Oh boy. Dan circles you. He wrenches his neck to the side, cracking it to loosen it up, then laughs.
I owe you this from a few weeks ago.
All right.
You're gonna bleed, bitch.
Swing it, Dan. Grapple Dan. Or stab him. As Dan comes at you with a punch, you duck low and tackle him. At first he laughs, bringing his foot down on your back, widening his stance to avoid falling. And you execute a perfect suplex. You slam Dan on the ground, arching your back to the fullest. Before he can recover, you maneuver him into a rear naked choke. He tries to pull your arm away, but he's no match for your strength. He taps your arm for a sec, then quickly loses consciousness. You release before doing any permanent damage.
Nice moves.
Okay, and looking at the grapple choice, choice 1 leads to a bad end. Well, that was kinda nuts, not gonna lie. Jeez.
Step 2 is easy.
Okay. What do I have to do? Even though I'm afraid to ask. Lilianna snaps her fingers, and one of the other delinquents carefully hands her a syringe. Oh boy.
Do you know what this is?
Oh hey, that's my mom's medicine! Weird! Looks like dark chocolate. I'm afraid both of those answers are probably wrong. Well, this choice doesn't matter because they're both wrong in the end, so why not? Wheel of Morality, turn, tell us the lesson we should learn.
Funny. It's Rapture, up from Mexico.
Okay.
Take it. Stick him.
She points down at Dan.
Got it.
Okay, let's see here. Choice 1 leads to a bad end. Okay, well... Let me see here. I can't give this to a kid, you monster. I don't waste anything. Poke! Well, I obviously can't do that if I want to. So, yeah. Choice 1 leads to a bad end. Well, let's just see here. I may see if I can go back and try to fail joining the gang, but we'll see. It all depends on what happens next. All around you, members of the gang react with shock and surprise. Cassie gasps, and even Lilianna looks shocked for a moment.
Respect, stranger.
Find out what it means to me.
But that's going to make this next part a lot harder.
Then why the hell did you... Well, as if I need to ask.
Okay, last step. Fight me.
Alright, let's see here.
Do it, and you're in.
Okay.
Lily, this isn't necessary! The Nate is gonna mess with them too much!
You never know. Might help. Ready?
Okay, well... Let's see here... So what you want to do is fight as best as you can. But... Well, let me see here. Why don't I actually try to fail this, and we'll see where it goes. So, yeah, I'm gonna throw in the fight, and I guess I'm just gonna kind of mess around a bit, and then we'll see if I can get that bad ending for her. Lilianna moves in, her fists are up. She moves with uncanny speed and skill. The first three hits to your face barely register as pain. The drugs in your system are dragging everything down. You swing, blind. The world feels like honey. Everything goes dark. You awake suddenly in a cold sweat. You quickly hear Cassie's voice. Okay. You look around. You're in your room. It's dark. Cassie is undressed. She was sleeping next to you. You ask what happened, and Cassie hesitates for a moment.
You're in.
I'm in? Wait, if I fail to join the game... I didn't fail to join the gang!
Lilianna was impressed.
Well, even when I try to fail, it looks like... Okay, well... I guess it's a good thing I made that other save, then. So... Man, it's like, even when I'm trying to fail, I don't do it. Okay, well...
Step two is easy. Yeah, it's rapture.
No, well... That ain't what dark chocolate is! Okay. So then... Wow, so... Yeah, so I guess I'm just gonna be like... Yeah, hell no, I'm not doing this. Lilianna reaches behind herself, pulls out a small handgun, and places it to the back of Cassie's neck. Oh sure, go ahead and drag her into it when she didn't have anything to do with this. Okay... Ugh. I don't even have any words right now. Cassie makes a sound, a gasp, almost like surprise. The blood begins to pour out of her mouth. She slumps to the ground and you feel yourself fall to your knees. Before you can rush Lilianna, she turns and shoots you four times. Pain explodes in your chest, your leg, your stomach. Lilianna hands her gun to one of her delinquents.
Hack him up. Drop him in the alley for that bitch detective to find. Show him what rats get.
There's so much blood on your hands, running down your thigh, your stomach. You slump to the ground and everything goes dark. You got the blood in the warehouse ending. Why is that bad ending number one? Lilianna won't take no for an answer. Try to be more subtle if you want to resist her demands. Okay, I guess I may have to go back a little bit further to try to fail joining the gang. Alright, let's see. Okay, well, I'm back here. But then, well, if I'm supposed to resist her and it's telling me to be more subtle... This ain't being subtle.
Yeah, I know.
Ugh! Again with this shit? How am I supposed to fail joining the gang if... Okay, fine. Let me go back even further. Probably to that one where I made just outside the warehouse.
I see.
Well, I guess while I'm here, what are they going to try to make me do?
It's a bit different for everyone. I mean, they probably won't make you do what I did.
Oh boy, I can only imagine.
Which was mostly a bunch of math involving stash cutting.
Oh, okay, well.
I don't think Lilianna is going to ask you to jump her or anything, but just brace yourself. You're seen as a bit of a threat.
Am I now? At that moment, Lilianna finishes up with the person she's talking to and blah 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 blah.
I don't believe you.
It seems like nothing I do is really working. Like, it just seems as though, how am I supposed to fail this, or fail getting into the gang? I don't think there's any way that I can fail getting into the gang, as weird as it sounds. Either I do this, and Cassie and I die. And if I try to go somewhere in between, it looks like I still manage to get in anyway.
Yeah.
Well, can I just take a swing at him and look like a total wimp? You square up with Dan and take a swing. He's surprisingly fast on his feet, sidestepping your attack and punching you in the eye. The blow opens a cut on your eye, and your vision quickly blurs. From there, things go from bad to worst. Dan beats you savagely, kicking you in the teeth, in the crotch, in the neck. On the edge of consciousness, unable to stand, Lilianna signals for the fight to stop. Cassie is crying, but trying not to make a sound. Lilianna kneels down close to you, so she can whisper to you alone.
Listen, I know you've been talking to that detective.
Oh, great.
I let you try out tonight because I wanted to see if you were a rat.
Huh?
But since you lost, you and Cassie are no good to me. I know one of you is the rat. I think it's her.
Okay, well, looks like she figured it out.
So this is goodbye.
Is this goodbye as in you're gonna wave to me as I leave out of here, or goodbye as in you're gonna shoot us both for dead? Lilianna signals for the other delinquents to approach. They grab Cassie, who screams in surprised rage. Someone hits you in the head with something. Oh my god. You awake later, too injured to move. Yeah. This is the tragic ending for Cassie. This is what I saw. Cassie stares at you from across the street. Only she doesn't. Cassie isn't there anymore. It's hours before the police find you, and then you lose consciousness again, the darkness coming for you. You got the bad gang ending. Well then, God, it seems like, okay, well then, I guess this isn't going to be an ending that I can get. Because it almost seems as though no matter what I do, I either end up dying, or it looks like I end up getting into the gang anyway. So yeah, obviously we can't break her. You can fight as best as you can or struggle to remain consciousness, which I did. But then I still got in anyway. Oh, God. So it tells you to just fight as best as you can, and then if you fail to join the gang, you'll get Cassie's shop till you drop and the next night. But I can't fail! So, if I can't fail, then I guess I'm just gonna keep playing through as much as I don't want to. You wait for Lilianna to swing, and you manage to dodge her attack. You see frustration flare across her expression. She swings again, but you're already swinging your uppercut. You catch her on the chin. You actually manage to lift her off the ground with the force of your blow. A weaker chin, and she would have fallen unconscious. But Lilianna laughs.
Hey, that's a good hit. You're pretty good.
She hits you, but it barely matters. The drugs have already done their work. You fall, and everything goes dark. You awake in a cold sweat, and... And we're back in here.
Lilianna was impressed.
Even though I was trying to fail, but... Yeah, I don't know how you'd be able to fail getting into the gang without somebody dying.
Now, rest.
Cassie gently presses you to the bed. I don't like where this is going. You fall asleep again. You can hear the storm pouring rain outside, and the sound ferries you back to sleep almost instantly. Cassie is gone by the time you awake, several hours later. Sundari Tamer, A+ on Cassie's 4th date. Well, yeah, so I guess we're not gonna get that bad ending, but... Like I mentioned, I don't think that's the chibi death. But damn, it seems like... Who knew it was so hard to fail getting into that gang? Alright! I forgot, we still have this to deal with. Oh, and the guide's even trying to be funny here. Didn't we wake up the next morning? Maybe we found Fumi's time machine. Yeah, that's true. We woke up in the morning, but now it's night again. Because we can't miss Mio's stream. Logging onto your computer, you immediately get a notification that Mio's livestream will be starting in a few minutes. Oh, God. Let's see what we're gonna do here. Well, Mystic said that we're gonna need like a shit ton of money, right? Taking care to turn on your VPN and sign in with a dummy email account, you set your username to Rapid the Porcupine and join the stream. Okay. Were you guys a fan of the original G4? Well, specifically X-Play. Yeah, and I guess specifically a fan of Crazy Adams Discount Warehouse and Import Emporium! Well, it's finally happened and I've completely gone crazy! At least that's what the demons in my head tell me! But I'll show them who's crazy! And there she is. It's not Mega Man. And she's not one of the Phantom Thieves. Chat room, username. A girl in a mask comes on screen. You recognize it's Mio right away. She's speed running Mega Woman 4. One of the hardest the NES one exists. Or who knows, maybe the NES does exist. Super Mario Bros. 2 exists.
The strat here is to wall clip through the stage just enough to hit the end zone trigger without falling out of bounds. So it might look like I'm just humping the wall for a few seconds, but I swear that's just the glitch.
Never missing a beat, I see.
Members only streaming hasn't started yet, I promise. Lol.
Oy vey.
I know. I use that joke every stream. I only have, like, 4 jokes, so go easy on me, chat.
Hey, well, that's probably, like, 4 more jokes than I have. Anyhow.
Okay, here we go.
You indeed watch Mega Woman bump into the wall 8 or 9 times. Mio purses her lips in concentration.
Ugh, I'll get it, but I don't think I'm on pace for PB.
Mega Woman bumps several more times and she suddenly clips into the wall. The screen flashes, mission complete. Or should I say, mission complete!
Yay! Good job, Mega Woman! Keep doing that and you'll pay off your college loans in no time.
Oh god, I feel...
Speaking of college loans, it's actually time for me to sign off and start the members-only stream.
After hours.
Yeah, I know. Send me all your internet hate. But your tears don't buy me energy drinks, so I gotta put up the paywall. I get it. I'm evil. Rar. But in all seriousness, thank you so much for subbing and watching my stream. I couldn't do it without you. I'm so happy you spent time with me today.
Yes, I time traveled back to tonight just to be here.
Okay, Gamer Galaxy out. Bye.
Members only for after hours. Hack into the system. Leave, you'd rather not watch. The stream cuts out and a different screen pops up that says, become a member to access members only area. Warning, you must be... Okay, well. It's time to... Well, I just realized it's almost 420k. Well, here we go. You enter your credit card information and hit accept. Oh boy, I'm just here wondering, how is this actually going to play out? When the stream finally loads, Mio is there speaking to the chat.
Yeah, I'm so excited for Foible 3, but really, I love any game that lets you marry 12 waifus and customize their hair. I'm just saying, if a game has waifus and hair customization, I'm there. I don't care if it's matching 3 or fighting skeletons. Yo, thanks Rapid the Porcupine for the tier 1 sub. Welcome to the stream.
Rapid the Porcupine! Okay. What am I supposed to say here? Long time lurker, first time sub. So the legends were true. Beautiful girls can play video games. Oh god. Orale, cochino, control yourself.
Aw, thank you! Make sure to smash the gong and click register and all that.
Yeah, clearly what all the interwebs tell you to do.
And most importantly, make sure to fill out this week's cosplay council form so I know which character I should do a saucy cosplay for next.
Okay. Will I be able to get the rank of master though? So I can sit on the council.
Okay, we should start the stream.
Okay. I have no idea what I'm in for. Neil pauses for a moment, her gaze off screen as she clicks through a program on her computer. Then she turns back and gives the camera a wink.
All right, time to get into uniform.
Oh my god. We haven't even started and I'm already here. Like, what am I doing? And oh, Rabbit the Porcupine is actually on there. God, I'd have to actually, like, zoom in on some of this stuff. Does that say GG and everything? Yeah. I have no idea if these would be actual, like, usernames somewhere. The soundtrack suddenly changes, switching to a song much more burlesque and saucy. Mio stands up, turns away, and changes outfits off-screen. There's a sudden uptick in donations in the chat. A dozen small tips pop up on the screen, along with a $50 tip from GG is Everything. Okay, well, I did read that right.
Okay, slow down, everyone. I was just getting my game face on.
Man, I have no idea how this is gonna turn out.
Alright, welcome everyone to Seductive Speedrunning, my members only channel.
Oh, jeez.
Usually I have a bunch of achievements I'm working on, but today is a little different. Today we're doing the pay-to-win auction.
Is it weird that I found it oddly seductive the way she said the seductive speedrunning? But yeah, here's the auction that we have to win no matter what.
Once a month, I auction off a personal one-on-one session as part of a sexy speedrun. Whomever wins gets to pick what we get up to. I'll game, I'll chat, I'll take requests.
Oh boy.
The money for the auction goes half to my bills, but I always donate the other half to local wildlife charities. Because someone needs to get naked for animals. We'll be starting the auction in a few minutes. I just need to take a super short break and I'll be right back. Play nice, I'll BRB.
Mio gets up and leaves. Meanwhile, the chat is flashing by fairly quickly, and you read what the other bidders are saying. While most of the comments are pretty cringy and thirsty, you notice there's the usual mix of sarcasm and support you've come to expect from the internet. Reviewing GG is Everything's messages, though, you notice some of them stand out.
Galaxy! Why didn't you stream last week like you said you would? You never explained yourself! I want to know what you're doing! Galaxy! Did you get my DM?
Okay. That's my imitation of an annoying internet troll. Okay, well. No, I guess. I'll stop doing that because I'm going to annoy myself. I need you to answer me right away. GG, you need to kick most of the losers from this chat. Everyone who hasn't donated at least $1,000 are filth. Don't ignore me. I need you to answer my questions. Hey GG, is everything thirsty much? Get yourself control. GG is everything. You need to tone it down. You're borderline rude right now. Let me see. This doesn't matter. Just for the sake of not drawing too much attention to myself here, I'm not gonna say anything. GG is everything continues his triad, even though Mio is off camera. At least save it for when she's there. It looks like the chat is mostly trying to avoid a direct confrontation with him. Yes, which I think is the smarter thing to do. Oh god. Mio comes back on camera shortly after, humming a certain Russian puzzle game theme. I am the one who arranges the blocks as they descend upon me from up above. They come down and I spin them around until they fit in the ground like hand in glove. There. She quickly reads the chat, and you can see a look of concern briefly cross her face. Yeah, because remember the whole stalker thing? I'm just saying.
Okay, we're ready to start. Does everyone remember the rules?
No.
This is the pay-to-win speedrun auction, which means it's evil and shady and terrible, but it's for a good cause. I'll be playing Endless Running Mechanical Pegasus. If I beat my PB, then you all lose and I get to laugh at you.
No idea what this might be a spoof on, but okay.
But if I lose, then you guys get bragging rights, and you get to make fun of me for letting saucy thoughts overcome my competitive gaming spirit. And whoever has donated the most by the end wins the special prize, which is the one-on-one session.
Which I can only imagine our stalker friend would love to get a handle on.
Alright, get your bets set. I'll load up the game, flip the on switch, and the competition is go!
The chat fills with catcalls and fans telling her she's going to lose. For the most part, everyone is joking around and trying their best to flirt with Mio. Well, I mean, now she's giving you I want you eyes. Okay, well. Yeah, I don't know what this would be a spoof of. It reminds me more of Neon Cat than anything right now. The title screen for Endless Running Mechanical Pegasus appears, and Mio selects new game. Her mouse hovers over a button that says, "Begin the magic!"
Alright, ready, set, go!
Oops. Just as Mio hits the start button, there's a flood of donation, mostly around $5 to $10. Mio gasps and laughs.
Ah! Okay, we're going. Focus, Mio!
Wait, donate $5 or donate $500? Okay. So we're going to donate $500 off the bat here. Go big or go home is probably the strategy that you're going to have here. I lost my 420 already, but... As soon as you click confirm on your larger donation, a large pop-up appears that you've done an Omega Attack! Mio's laugh quickly transitions into a quick gasp. And she takes her eyes off the screen for just a moment.
Jeez, Rapid the Porcupine! Let a girl warm up first!
There's a reason they call me Rapid the Porcupine! I don't know what that is, but... Okay, and well. God. I imagine anyone who never watched the good version of X-Play... They're probably confused by what I'm doing, like, why do I sound like a used car salesman? Well... It would take me too long to explain. Anyhow.
Thanks for, everything. Phew. Okay, the next kingdom is coming up. This is the first stage with the Medusa heads, so you've got a better shot of winning if you distract me here. Good luck!
As Mio's Pegasus leaps into the dungeon, a large donation suddenly pops up on the screen. Okay, is it going to be from our GG friend? Yes, it is. It says GG's Everything has donated $1,000 Omega Attack. Mio gasps and holds her breath for a few seconds.
Oh, wow. That must have been a donation from GG is Everything.
Oh god, I have no idea. I'm just here like... This is so weird, and I'm just like, well, I guess I'll figure out how this ends up on YouTube. I mean, we haven't gotten into like super, super crazy territory yet, at least I don't think so. Mio quickly checks the screen. She seems a little breathless and her cheeks are flushed from the adrenaline.
Yeah, I was right.
Yep. And who knows if that is actually our stalker in question.
Thanks, Gigi. You always have a way of making an entrance.
Yes. And Gigi always has a way with words, it seems. A flood of smaller donations kicks in, and Mio sticks her tongue before turning back to the game. Donate 5,500 bursts. Don't donate. Donate $2,000! Alright. Well, the guys even here are like, I feel like these requirements are all super obvious. Why am I bothering to write it down? I don't know, maybe because this game could throw me a curveball at any time and I'm here like, the obvious choice might not work. Like, look at how I failed to get into Liliana's gang. I thought some of it would have actually worked, but then it's like, nope. You either fail or you die. Anyhow. $2,000! You set up your donation to fire just as Mio is reaching the end of the kingdom where she's more likely to fail. When you confirm the donation, Mio reacts immediately.
Oh my god, that was a big donation! Who the heck did that?
Mio checks the chat quickly and smiles. The other people in the chat are cheering and laughing at her reaction. Kono no Dio da! Okay, no. Dio is not here.
Thanks for the donation, Rapid. You almost had me, but I'm hitting my PB no matter what today.
Mwah. Mio blows a kiss to the camera, then shakes her head a bit to try and focus one more on the game. Get your head in the game! You suddenly receive a direct message from Gigi is everything. Oh boy, it's probably be like, hey, you're muscling in on my territory. Hey, punk. Just what the hell are you trying to pull? If you think you're going to steal the one-on-one from me, you're wrong. And you'd better reconsider trying. Yeah? Or else what? See you later. Hack his computer. Bitch, I got cash for days. Here, have some. Oh god. Well. Okay, you can't write that word down, but you can write all the other stuff down. Really? Yeah, apparently you can't write this stuff here, but everything else they've written is fine. Being like, I got money to throw! I don't even care right now! You're going to regret that. Make it rain, embarrass the Gamer Galaxy Super Fan of the Week. Throw some glitter to make it rain. As Mio starts the next kingdom, Gigi is everything makes another Omega attack donation. When the pop-up appears, it says Gigi is everything donated $8,000. I probably gave him the ammunition for that, let's be real. But, I mean, that's what I'm supposed to do. Yeah, so it's like, here's $5,000. You can do with it whatever. So he's just like, screw that. I'm gonna use it for this. Mio almost drops her controller, gasping. The energy bar next to her portrait maxes out. Okay, I'll take your word for it. Mio throws her head back in. You only have a split second to act. Log out, there's no way to win. Show Mio the threatening message from whatever, and donate $16,000! If you don't have the money, choose to expose the troll. Well, I mean, I do have it, but that's like freaking half of what I got! Oh, God! Oh, great! I'm gonna hate myself for this. I'm really gonna hate myself for this. Your donation quickly replaces Gigi as everything's replacing you at the top of the auction rankings. The adrenaline and shock of receiving such a large amount of money is too much for Mio to handle. She gasps and drops her controller. I can only imagine how this might play out in the other version. Mio's Pegasus goes crashing into a beige troll, and a gruesome "You died" screen appears. She did not beat her personal best. After clicking through the donation, Mio pauses for a moment to type a message, then smiles.
Alright everyone, as you can see from the results, it looks like Rapid the Porcupine won the auction.
It feels so surreal hearing Rapid the Porcupine. I even used to make fun of it, like, when I had a friend and we used to watch X-Play. And, like, even, like, some people on YouTube watching, like, old clips of it. Yeah, I just remember stuff like people saying, like, I really want to play Yellow Pie Man. Or elevators, an interactive experience.
Congratulations, Rapid. You're, really good at donating.
Seriously, that was like half of what I had. Well, not including the fact that I went in there with 40,000 or 40,000, and now I'm down to 16,000.
As I mentioned earlier, half of tonight's donations will go to charities for animals. The rest will help me afford ramen and new cosplay. Thanks again to everyone who joined me tonight. Rapid, please stay logged in. I'll set us up a private room.
Okay, well, let's see. You thought it was Rapid the Porcupine, but it was me, ArdrethShadow, all along!
Good night, everyone! Gamer Galaxy, signing off!
Oh wait, I just realized. GG. I think this is the Stalker. I thought it was Good Game is Everything, but no, it's Gamer Galaxy is Everything. Well. Yeah, I guess, how to make yourself look like a stalker without automatically saying, hey, I'm a stalker. The chat fills with messages of smirks and tears. Oh wait, let me get my cup so I can drink all these tears. And soon it goes quiet.
So, Rapid, it's just the two of us now. Did you, enjoy the show?
I wonder if she knows. Something tells me that she does, but who knows.
Sorry, that always sounds really weird, saying stuff like that after such an active session.
What's up with that GG is everything guy? Seems pretty unhinged. I enjoyed it. You're really hot. You're really hot. I mean, it combined my two favorite things, donating money and running Pegasus. Okay, that's what you're supposed to say.
Wow, we have so much in common.
I know, how convenient.
Well, Rapid, the night is young and the time is yours. Since this is your first one-on-one, you're probably not totally sure what's up, but I'm all yours. What would you like to do? What would you like me to do? Can I do something special for you?
Oh boy, just to imagine what you could do in the other version of the game, and she's giving me the I want you eyes again! Okay, well, wow, well, okay, this is actually kind of a lot more tame than I thought.
Your pick.
I want to watch you try on cosplay. I've got you for a few hours, let's play a game. Do you mind walking me through how to build a good PC? Yeah, these are surprisingly tame compared to what I could have imagined you doing. She's surprised too. I just want to have a nice wholesome night. I just died like 5 times and lost my mind, kind of, so...
Like, really? Like, really, really?
Apparently so.
That is hilarious. I've never been asked to provide sexy tech support. This is exciting new territory.
Does that mean yes? Please, I'm too scared to ask the internet, but you have to be nice, right? Just kidding, I want to watch you. Okay. You want to be like, does that mean yes?
It means absolutely.
Of course!
Hold on, I'll grab some common tools and components I've got laying around. I'm going all out here.
Oh, man.
Oh, and, let me know if my boobs are too distracting or whatever.
You and Mia wind up spending hours talking about PC components, a topic she seems particularly passionate about.
And then, yeah, you're basically done.
We're just gonna skip all the PC talk and skip right to the end here. Okay, the next choice doesn't matter.
I mean, you could still pick a bunch of aesthetic upgrades, but I usually start with those. I suppose we kind of skip them.
Well, yeah. Me personally, I would just want to have something that just gets the job done. Anything else can come later.
Oh wow, look at the time. I should hit the hay. But thank you so much. This was the weirdest but coolest one-on-one session I've ever had. It'll be hard to beat. Will I see you at the next auction? I promise you don't need to pay me if you just want to hang out and play games. I'll give you a coupon for those.
I'll be there. My pleasure, Gamer Galaxy. I'm sure we'll talk again soon. Sooner than you think.
I look forward to it. Good night.
Good night. And done. Mio turns off the stream, and you stand up from your computer chair for the first time in several hours. The dawn is here. You awake to your alarm. It's the local news. It tells the residents of Sabrosa to hunker down. Then an ad for the mall comes on, declaring $50 off umbrellas. It's the end of the world sale! Jeez. Okay, well, I guess screw it. I'm gonna do my modeling in the daytime because I didn't get to do my modeling at night. I need to recover after that. Okay, well, let me see here. Okay, after looking through the guide a bit, I have not missed Cassie's chibi death. Although, yeah, as unfortunately as it is, I did get the actual tragic death. So, I am very sorry for all of you out there, but, well, I guess since I'm technically, well, this isn't really 100% anyway because this person didn't even, or they couldn't manage to get all of these achievements either, so there's a few of them that they missed out on. But obviously, those you would get from playing kind of bad to just simply missing out on certain key events with the girls. So, you know, since the object of this playthrough is to try to get as much through everything as possible, I probably wouldn't be able to get those either unless I were to start a whole new playthrough and purposefully play terrible. Alright, well, this video is going to be pretty long, though, so I am not getting a clear picture in my crystal ball, so I'm going to tell you this really quick, in case things get really weird. It is possible to date every girl, find every secret, buy every one of my hints, date every side character, and score perfect on every date. You don't need to do all those things to get the best ending. But how to get the best ending? Well, that's a bit beyond the power of a hendoscope. I think you'll need to get them straight from the crystal ball, so to speak. Good luck. And suave. And all the skills. You're going to need them. Cheers. Well, I mean, I think with suave especially, I'm like stupidly overpowered. Like, I have almost doubled that of my tech savvy here. So, you're in now. You're in the game. I still can't believe it either. And part of me is so sorry. I feel like I'm gonna break down and bawl my eyes out. But there's another part of me that wonders if maybe you're my way out. So I'm gonna do something I normally don't do. I'm gonna hope. And I hope, most of all, you haven't made a terrible mistake. I guess we'll see. I'm glad you're with me, though. Thank you for the most incredible date in my life. Thank you. And though... I can't believe it either! Especially when I tried to fail! I couldn't fail! Well, actually, no, I could fail, but it would have led to somebody dying here. Alright, well. Yeah, we're really, really getting into, like, the nitty-gritty here. Okay, well, yeah, I think this video session... Well, yeah, this recording session has gone on long enough. It's almost... We're almost approaching 2 hours again. Maybe even more, so... Okay, well... Yeah, like I said, we're in the nitty-gritty now. I don't know what is gonna happen. But... We will see. So, thank you all for watching. And I'll see you guys next time with whatever else I do. Stay golden, and later, folks.